Hello and welcome, viewers and subscribers of AVG News. Olise, the son of Nube, is my name, and I'm here just to respond to a message that has been asked by a number of people. That is a question that has been asked by a number of people during the past week or so. I thought maybe people have read about it on the news and they already have it within their reach, but now it seems that there have been some twists and turns, and people want to know because many of them are worried as to what exactly is happening. It concerns the allegations of death threats that have been leveled or directed at the South African Minister of Home Affairs, that is Dr. Aaron Motsoaledi. So people want to know if this is indeed true or it's fake news. So this is what I wanted to respond to, and I will respond to it and also attach a video of the minister speaking to one of the television channels in South Africa about this. So what we know so far is that the Minister of Home Affairs, Dr. Aaron Motsoaledi, has received several death threats which are allegedly from someone who claims to be a paid assassin, and then who contacted the minister, and he says that he was contracted to kill the minister by some people. So Motsoaledi has already handed over this matter, according to what he says, to the HAWKS, that is this specialized crime unit in South Africa, for investigation. And he says the motive of his death, of these death threats, are yet to be known because the person hasn't said who sent them and why. So in a recent interview with the ENCA, that is eNews Channel Africa, he said that he has received several phone calls, 8 of them on a single day, from a man who claims that he was paid to kill him, and he tried to extort money from the minister by attempting to negotiate. And he says that if the minister pays him more than that, more than what he was paid by those who contracted him, he's then going to kill those people who hired him and spare the minister. So the minister says he's looking into the matter seriously, and that is why he has handed it over to the HAWKS. So this is what we have, and we'll leave you listening to the Minister of Home Affairs. But what we have also, Goren, is that there are a number of people, especially those that are known to be in business, who have received similar threats from people claiming that they've been sent or contracted to kill them, and they will be negotiating a higher fee higher than what they claim to have been paid by their contractor. So we don't know for certain if this person was hired to kill the minister, or is just some scammer who's trying to extort money from the minister using these death threats. But of course, the minister did well to then conduct the works and hand this over, because either way, this is a crime we cannot be left lying low, because the minister's life is very precious. He is a human being. He is a vital cog in the South African government, and he mustn't be threatened, and he must always be safe. And we hope and pray that this particular person will be arrested, and that the HAWKS will get to the bottom of this matter and make sure that this doesn't persist. So thank you very much. We'll leave you listening to the minister speaking about these death threats. And then don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video and share it.
Well, I'm looking at it seriously. That's why I immediately handed it over to the HAWKS. Immediately the threat was made. And the HAWKS have been running with the issue. And they can give you more information about it.
How many times has this happened? What kind of a threat was it?
Yo, when you say how many times, you mean it's a little bit of a confusing question.
Continuous thing.
No, this particular one was one individual. He was phoning up to 6-8 times a day. You know.
And we don't know what it's in relation to.
No, no. He said he has been sent to assassinate me. They've paid me money and he wanted to pay me to pay more, so that he assassinated the people who sent him rather than me. In other words, it was a beating process. It was a beating process that I've got so much to kill you. If you pay me so much, I'll kill the other guy.
We don't know what the motive is.
I know. I wasn't told the motive at all.
So they're investigating now, currently?
Well, they've been investigating, Pule, and I think they've made a lot of progress, but I can't disclose it. It's for police to, not me.